across here, hit across. But I just wanted to say good morning to you all. I did not get to see my grandkids. It's a little too far away from me coming out. And all that kind of good stuff. But I got to come back through here towards Phoenix in a couple days. So I'm going to try to set it up where it's in the afternoon. Hopefully after leave a load or I get situated where I come through in the afternoon. It'll be after school time for them. Sorry about the camera there. It's in concrete roads. I'm literally going by LSU. I am born and raised in Atlanta, Georgia. I did go to the University of Georgia and Morehouse. Morehouse College. Say what's up to my frat brothers. Phi Beta Sigma. Operation Blue Storm. 92, I know, 91. This year will be 30 years. In December will be 30 years. Wow. 30 years. Wow. Anyway, we get on down this road a little bit. And I'll get up with you all when I get stopped for fuel. Yeah, I want to make sure you all get a view of that bridge. We're going up going through Baton Rouge here. Realized I read my permit wrong or my provisions for the permit. I couldn't make it further than what I was because of my evening curfew. But because I'm not 12 wide or greater, I can't go through New Orleans, Lord, through Baton Rouge at 379. So I'm heading through that now. Yeah, that sunrise, about to get somebody. But anyway, yeah, so we'll get through here, head on across. I'm gonna stop in Alabama, get some fuel. And you keep it moving. And we'll keep it moving. Had a pretty good night's sleep though. Pretty good night. Always love going across this bridge. The old bridge. Steel bridge. Concrete. Everything I pull. Or have pulled. By here, it's 42 degrees. I haven't been this cold in, shoot, since going towards Texas. I mean, towards California from New Jersey 2 weeks ago. I've been down in Texas for the last 2 weeks, 2-3 weeks.
Sunset.
So you realize, as I said, you know, earlier, got to look at these permits. You got to, even though I looked at the one last night, for Louisiana, I misread it. Me and my permit, yeah, we both misread it. The provisions state, you know, when I can go through this city of my Baton Rouge. But it was a good thing about that when I passed by that truck stop, I was trying to stop where I could see my grandkids. I couldn't have got in, and I would have been stuck on the on an on ramp or something. And I do not, you're not supposed to anyway, stay on a on ramp or exit ramp. So I don't like doing that. I've done that once out in Texas. I really don't, because they call it a sitting duck. And if anybody hit you, it's your fault, even though you're just sitting there. But you're not supposed to be there. It's a legal parking. But I know out west, they do it a lot now. Here in out east, Georgia, Tennessee, Kentucky, I know they will knock on your door and give you a ticket for you to move. Whether you're on your 10-hour break, your 30-minute break, it don't matter. You gotta move it out there, man. You're gonna leave with a ticket. But, you know, other than that, we're just rolling down this road here in the east. I got my boat anchor back there, but everything's good. The load is good. Tomorrow morning when I get up, we'll go through a pre-trip inspection. There's nothing to it, really, just making sure everything is everything on it. Despite the thing, and like now, when my pre-trip this morning, I got a light out on my trailer. Bring my tail light. I guess tail light and brake light. So when I stop on my 30-minute break today, and it's about 60 or 70 miles, I'm light. I think I got one in my truck. It's supposed to have extra stuff, but I pulled so many different trailers. You know, some trailers had a new pan lights, LEDs, some had the old ones. You know, it just depends on what kind of trailers. I can't keep all the lights in stock on my truck. I know it will not. You know, but thank you. Harris Stadium. I heard he just passed too. I don't listen to the news as much as I used to. Wow. But Hank Aaron and Larry King. But anyway. I-10 going east to I-65 north to I-165 south to 89. Go south a couple miles to get off at Main Bridge Road, something like that. Main-wise, Main Bridge, whatever it is. Make a left and take it back down to the other side of Mobile. It's about a 15, 20 mile detour around the city there. You can't go through the tunnel. In Mobile with our oversized loads, or hazmat for that matter. Right now we're on the west side of Mobile. I mentioned the ports in Mobile. There's a lot of stuff going on over there. All the ports, a lot of stuff. Look at that. They got one move today. Getting on in their illusion. That's just close to that. Close to that it look. The side of the building says no perfect people allowed. Ain't that the truth? Nice day out today. It's cold. Oh my goodness, it's cold. I was getting fuel over there and I'm exit 13 and now Alabama going eastbound on I-10. Like to froze out there. Earlier when I was saying something about that light, trying to find out the light was just unplugged. I didn't have to buy one. I didn't have one in my box either. Which means I need to re-up and slide up to the left a little bit. Got a little bit of something going on up here. Let's slow it down. We got a bus broke down. Bus broke down. Right in the middle lane. Wow. Nothing good about that. Oh, somebody hit it. Railways. Haven't seen them around in a while. Supposed to hit the fuel tank or something. I don't know. The fuel tank is right there, but anyway. Not able to move. Get on around this corner and holler at you all in a little bit. Good people, we have made it to just north of Gainesville, Florida. We're ready to pull into a rest area here. Heading down to Fort Lauderdale. Not close to home, but close enough. A long day. It's like every way station I came to. Louisiana to the last one on I-10 there in Madison, near Madison, Florida. Pull me in, get paperwork in, you know, so that took time. That took 5 to 10 minutes at a time. Then I, you know, go park, go get paperwork out, go in, hey, you good to go, get back out, go in the truck, get back on the road again. It's not going to take that long, but it really does, man. You got to slow down from your speed, and you got to get back to your speed. But, you know, that's all good. It's all about oversized loads. Not all about it, but, you know, that's what we had to do with these loads. But, you know, just try to obey the law. Ain't no use in going in that fight, because if you got something wrong, you're gonna pay the fine. You might as well just go ahead and just let them have at it. They had to fight another day.
But we'll get it here and get settled in,
and I'll get back with you all in a little bit and close it out. We got parked. Right now I'm doing my post-trip inspection, which is basically letting the truck idle, not idle down, but cool down some and idle. I get out, walk around, make sure my flags and stuff in there, my tires are not overheated. Nothing's dripping up under the car, the truck. Talked to my brother today, and we're looking into getting some, he's helping me find some attachments and stuff for a GoPro so I can actually show you all the loading and unloading. And for so much driving video you can watch. And I want to get one for my head so as I turn, you all can see what I'm looking at. But yeah, just what a long day we drove. Let's see how many miles. 610 miles and 9 hours and 50 minutes. Not bad, and that's with doing 55 in Louisiana. So, somebody parking over there to my left. I'm at a rest stop here, like I said, north of Ocala, right in Gainesville. Heading down to Fort Lauderdale. And yes, I am close to home. Wife and kids don't know. But I should be home either tomorrow night or Saturday morning. But I gotta leave back out Monday. Do a job in Florida, I hope I get that one. And then I have to leave and be from like, I think, Lakeland down to one of the mines in Mulberry, Florida. And then I'll leave and head to Orlando to pick up a forklift to take back out to Phoenix. And I'll be out there for the rest of the week. The following week, I'll be out there trying to work my way back here because my wife's birthday is the following week. So, and I have a doctor's appointment. I have a doctor's appointment on the 15th that I have to go to. I'll tell y'all about why. It's not with the heart or anything like that, DOT-wise. I'll give you all the 411 on that in a couple of videos. But anyway, like, subscribe, comment if you would like. I appreciate you all, you know, riding with me. You know, as always, be good. Treat each other with kindness. And we'll see y'all on the road again.